Manchester is a very special place. It truly is. It's the birthplace of the Industrial Revolution. It has over 20 Nobel Prize winners associated with discoveries in the city. And I think the operation here in Manchester feeds off of that. Some of the innovations the team here has brought to the market have been revolutionary. And with Synap, for instance, we're setting bars that our competitors can only dream about matching.
Where we are going to use the Synap for is to see what it can do in the field of structural biology. My lab is interested in structures of protein complexes, large protein complexes like whole viruses or whole ribosomes and proteasomes. We want to study these complexes by mass spectrometry. Now these complexes are very big for mass spectrometry. They sometimes have a mass of 1 million Dalton, so that's much larger than small molecules we usually look at. And this new Synap instrument has the capabilities to look at such large complexes. We have been working on this in this field already with the QTOF, which we specifically modified. But it looks like this Synap machine can do equally well as what we have now and even better. And of course also the ion mobility that tells you something about the shape of the structures of these large complexes is also an interesting feature, and that's why we are interested in the technology.
In universities nowadays, particularly in the top rank of universities which we're talking about here, research excellence is everything. Research excellence does not always mean developing new technologies. What we're looking to do is to solve important scientific problems. However, in order to do that, we need access to the most up-to-date, the most cutting-edge, the most sensitive, selective techniques that there are. And so our instruments that we use to solve our important scientific problems are absolutely key underpinning technologies.
In general, if we want to have therapy, if we want to interfere with life, healthy life and disease, then we have to understand how proteins work, and we have to understand how we can maybe change how they work using drugs. And these drugs might be anything, anti-cancer or anything antidepressive, whatever. If you understand the structure of your complex, you can understand the function better. So we directly learn how drugs work and also maybe what the adverse effects of drugs can be.
Clearly, when you enable a client to see something they've not seen before with, say, Synapt, it's very easy for them to understand how that can move their research interests forward. But also we have to build products that are very easy to use and can generate thousands of results in a day.
The Synapt has the advantage that we can do dynamic measurements so that we can study these biological systems whilst they're changing, whilst they're changing their activity, whilst they're being inhibited. And that's a crucial aspect to it. So the ability to be able to acquire your experimental data quickly, reproducibly, is a key aspect of the technology.
So I think that the best ideas come about through people talking to each other, discussing ideas, especially talking to customers. Customers have the problems to be solved. They tend to make us aware of something we hadn't considered before. They don't know necessarily whether there is a solution to this, but they make us aware that there's a need.
When we were starting work in the ion mobility area, the main driver was to try and establish a shape-selective approach to looking at protein misfolding diseases. Why is this important? Well, we had a problem, as the world does, of course, with mad cow disease, bovine spongiform encephalopathy, which it has been shown can lead to a similar disease in man, a new variant Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease. New variant CJD. And there's a problem there, which is that how do you tell whether an animal or indeed a human has this disease? The approach that we're using to address this issue is to work initially on recombinant prion proteins. We have already shown that with the recombinant materials that we can see differences between the cellular prion structure, i.e. the normal biological shape, and numerous misfolded prions that can be made in the laboratory. The next stage is to optimize that assay and then to move on to blood samples where initially we will dope them with the recombinant materials that we have to show recovery and sensitivity, and then finally to move on to infected animal blood samples, where we can show, hopefully, that we're able to differentiate between healthy animals and animals that are incubating this very long-term, very serious disease.
I see mass spectrometry as really the jewel in the crown. It's a critical technology for the corporation. And in terms of where it can go next, I could see it being used in so many different areas that it's almost mind-boggling to know where we could be in 5 years' time with the technology at our disposal. I sense that it will become a very routine type of instrument. It could be used to revolutionize the way healthcare is delivered. It could revolutionize the quality of our food supply. And the great thing is that we have all the inventions and tools and technologies kind of coming through our development pipeline to really enable that change to happen. It's a tremendous time for mass spectrometry. It's terrific. And I'm so proud that I can be associated with the team that's going to make that happen.